Good morning, all of you. So we'll continue with the problems related to this four chapters. So try to, again, you see the some of you are posting the mains questions. In fact, they are very trickier, especially the work point G. You look at the type of questions that are being asked now. So some you feel some sort of like some concept is what the small approximations or mathematical operations are being applied and the answers are brought. So check especially the mains papers for this particular topic. And among all, I feel work point G chapter with circular motion. There are some very good questions are there. Man, he will jump. Then what is work done by that? So these are the types of questions are there. A student need some idea of the diagrams, not just mere, work conversion of mechanical energy, work energy, or the work energy theorem, you can work out. The physical significance of that, if you know it, you can manage such questions. That one. Check one's mains papers, the work energy questions, that one. So you can say a little bit difficult. And unless you don't analyze, not possible, not straight away. Routine, like if you go for collisions, one-dimensional is very, very important. Then two-dimensional means rocket propulsion. There's a thing. Then conservation of momentum, very simple ideas. They don't be big. Center of mass, again, nothing big. So of these four chapters, only work energy or a little bit some good questions are available. So just be alert. So tomorrow when you go for final exam, okay, work energy, some good conceptual questions they will ask you. Conceptual means not like something thinking you have to work out again, but the physical significance or the situation you should understand clearly. Almost yesterday, some seven students, they posted questions and all seven questions are really very difficult for you. And always among the seven, six were from mains and one from NCERT book. Try to think on them. Okay. See, again, this topics, there is no end, like how kinematics, no wide varieties of questions here also. Overall, a general basic conditions, if we know it, no, to some extent, we can manage. I'm talking about advanced. Okay, we have a curved surface. Then this is the, I think that one. Okay, I'm going to release it. So this is the center. Some friction on curved surface already, I think you have come across here and there. Let me put it once again. So this, the eraser is telling, okay, this is like a block, we can treat it. I'm going to release. So somewhere at any RBT position, what are the conditions? We'll check it. So here, this is the M. So let this angle, anything you can write it as. So this is theta. Or this is theta, you write it. Or we'll take it, this is theta. Then how the friction force? The friction force will be acting in this direction. If this is theta, theta will be 0 to 45 degrees, no doubt. Mg sin theta or mg cos theta will come. I'll define this theta. It'll be easy for us. So this will become theta. So here mg, so mg sin theta will come into picture. This is a normal contact. So on this side, it will be mg cos theta. So what it's telling is like, well, the eraser will reach the lowest point of the track. So it will slide like this. From rest to rest, it will move and it will slide down slowly. Let's assume that one. Then what is the work done by friction? So work done by the friction should be equal to F into ds. Ds is the arc length. Or this will be mu n. Ds will be r d theta. Now what is d theta? D theta, we can define it like this. So that will be ds. I'm unable to show ds. So this will be mu mg cos theta r d theta. So mu mg cos theta d theta. Okay, this will be now theta. So mu mg r cos theta d theta. So what should be the limit? No, theta should be, I think, so shall we take it 0 to pi by 4? Or initial it was pi by 4, finally it will become 0. It does negative work, no? Okay, we'll put it. I think all symbols are missing. Okay, this will be negative sign. Sine theta. So mu mgr by root 2. Okay, this is the work done by friction. How much a decrease in gravitational potential you will? So that should be equal to mgr minus mgr cos 45. This is a work done or decreasing gravitational potential. Delta u, I'll write it. So what do you expect? This will be 0.7. 1 by 2 is 0.7. 0.7 will write it, or 0.7 we can take it. So this will become 0.3. mu mg 1 by root 2 will be 0.70 or 0.7. Mu is 0.6, no? Okay, this will be 0.7 into 0.6 mgr, 0.42 mgr. This is work done by friction. If the really the block moves from it will start from A to reach B. Then when it moves from A to B, delta UAB, I'll write it. Huh? This will be easier. How much it is? 0.3 mu mg, and mu is almost 0.6. So this will be 0.18 mgr, which will be greater. Work done by friction. So therefore, the block cannot reach B. Okay, agree. So the particle will never be able to go from A to B. Any reason what we can put it? WF is greater than WUAB. So the decrease in potential energy is less than the work done by friction. So therefore, the particle will never go from A to B. I think we have to cross verify things. What is the conclusion? So therefore, the particle cannot not be able to go from A to B. Therefore, will not be able to okay, this option C is what we have verified. Okay, let's take all the things one by one. Okay, just cross-checking. Okay, there's a method of getting that idea of the friction. Next again. if the particle slides from A to B, work done by frictional force will be. I think, okay, we have derived it. That is, that's what the formula. Okay, this is the correct option. If it slides from A to B, no, the particle will never be able to go from A to B. Is that correct? No, if the particle slides from A to B, work done by frictional force will be greater than. I think it should be, this is what equal, no? So check it now, this quantity is greater than this. I think no, pi is there here, he has brought pi also. I think should be less than, no? So this is not correct option. So this is correct option, I'll pick up. This is not correct. This is correct option. No, if mu is root 2, the particle will not begin to slide. How to justify this? I think at this particular thing, what is tan theta?
B is correct, no, sir.
Pi is there, no? 3.14, yes, by sir. 4. How much will
get? Pi by 4 is less than 1. The work done by friction will be greater than that value.
Even 4 is there in denominator, sir.
4 is there, huh? Okay, I didn't check. Yeah.
Sir, if it cannot go from A to B, then how we are... Why we are talking about the work done by friction, sir?
If I will move, if I will slide slowly, if particle slides, sir, if is telling.
Okay, sir.
This is a nice problem. Like already, I think in once in weekend exam it came. This is mu. Okay, what to do with this last option? If mu is root 2, the particle will not begin to slide. I think you check here, tan theta should be greater than mu, no? So yeah, at this particular point, tan 45, if mu is root 2, what will happen? It will not slide. I think it's correct statement. The particle will start its motion from here, so tan 45. So tan 45 is 1. What is mu? Mu is. So when the particle slide, when only when tan theta greater than mu. So for option D, what we can put explanation? Tan theta is less than mu. So therefore, particle will not slide. Because I'll release at A. At A only, it's 45 degrees. No, if you release at any other point, it will not slide, definitely. The particle will not begin to slide. More than one option, so different conditions will be applied. You have to be alert. Okay, this is a correct option we'll pick up. Okay, read the question. Try to understand first the question. It'll be very easy. All three are identical. Okay, this is just for my convenient, I just drew another separate diagram. So this is A, B, C. So this is a test. These two are moving with a velocity V. Okay, this is the initial, and they are lying on a horizontal surface. So first, the B will come and collide. The moment they collide, they will have common velocity. I'll read the question. I'm trying to construct overall the sequence. All are having same mass. Every time I need to indicate mass, it'll be like this. Then in next sequence, finally, all will have common velocity. Okay, there's the overall condition. So if you want, you could, no need to draw a diagram or the last. This diagram is very important. Until we don't have this, we cannot solve it. These are overall the problem. Demands a student has to have this much of imagination, is what I'm telling. You must have this much of imagination. Okay, at least I'm helping the diagram. Looking at the diagram now, you get into the problem solving. Okay, first plate, the plates B and C, board, or say what is saying board, the board B and C will collide. Okay, we'll come to the second and third diagram. So can we apply a conservation of linear momentum to get V1? Shall we apply conservation of linear momentum to get the V1? So applying conservation of linear momentum, initial momentum equal to final momentum. So based on that, 2mv equal to 3mv1. So v1 equal to 2v/3. Okay, this is something very important. After this, the final speed of each board is 2v/3. Okay, take this one. Next, what is the work done? Total work done. Look at the final kinetic energy. Will it be less than or greater than initial kinetic energy? Will be less than. So initial kinetic energy will have. Final kinetic energy will be 3 by 3, because finally all will have same kinetic energy. So this is the final 3 by 2 m. This will be 2 m v square by 3. Look at final. I think it is in fact less than initial. Where do this difference in kinetic energy get converted into work done to overcome the friction? So therefore, as work done by friction equal to delta K, Ki minus Kf. This should be mv square, 2mv square by 3. Or you write Kf minus Ki, so you get negative, means work was?
That is mv square minus 2 by 3 square.
Mv square minus, no, change in kinetic energy, so Kf minus Ki. Mv square. Three by is it okay calculation? So this is the negative sign, it will come. Okay, no. So this is the work done. So he's asking, there's a net work done by friction. It is this quantity, net work done by friction, we'll take it. Our total work done by friction force on C is telling, only on C. What was the initial kinetic energy of the C? It was attached. Finally, it is moving with. So work done by friction force, there's a net work done. Work done by frictional force on C will calculate. That should be equal to change in kinetic energy of m v1 square, m by 2, v1 is how much? 2 v by 3 whole square. So this will be 2 m v square by 9. It does positive work on the block C. So what is this? Work done by friction on board C. There's a network done by friction, this one. So the speed of final speed of each board is 2v by 3. Okay, there's no problem. Okay, we ended up this one. The total work done by friction force on the system is 0. Okay, this is ruled out. So what all we have, I put it. Now he's asking length of the board. From where the length of the board I can bring? How to bring length of the board? It's the next part of the discussion. For that, let me take help of this diagram. So here, let this have just after collision. So this will be V and V by 2. No? So here in the word action, the friction will act on A, and on this combined, these two, it will be this direction. The net work done by friction is what we have. Net work done by friction is what we are having. So after getting the net work done by friction, no? We know net work done by friction, and other side what will happen? I know work done by friction, I calculate here. By equating this, I can bring the length. Is this calculation, check it once, am I right?
Yes,
net work done by friction. Okay, yeah, then we'll proceed here now. No, how to calculate the work done, net work done by friction with help of, we have to bring this L into the picture. Friction does negative work on the block A, and it does positive work on the plank C. What about the normal contact here? This is N, this is MG, no? So what all that friction acting? Let's get into the calculation part. Work done by friction, this should be equal to
how mu and g, sir? There are two normal contacts, sir. One between A and B, one between A and C, and the friction is only due to the normal contact between A and C, no, sir.
Sorry. This is variable, no? This is. I'll bring into the picture. So F is equal to. It does negative work on the block. A friction will be acting this one, and it does positive work on the block C. So this will become F into D of XC minus XC. No. I think, okay, like, yeah, we'll keep this much of diagram. How to bring this particular part? So let me define the normal contact, because some XA length of the plank is on B and some XA length is on plank C. So let me define lambda. Lambda is mass per unit length. So shall we define now the normal contact is equal to lambda into XC minus XC into G. What all normal contact is, some part of A will be there on B and part of the length of board A will be there on C. So that XC minus XA is what we'll write here. So what is lambda? Lambda is M by L. This XC minus XA, let me call that as say some X. It will be easy for us to analyze things mathematically. So this will become F equal to mu n into dx. Mu, so this will become I have to go for next page, I'll write here in the corner. This should be equal to substituting F. This will be integral of M by L GX into DX. Mu should be there, no? Mu N. One more step, I'll write it. Mu N into dx. So mu into n will be m by l x g into dx. So this will be mu g m l. Now what should be the limit? Zero to l. Mu m g l by 2 will come. So we know other side, the net work done by the friction, substituting that, we'll get expression for this one. So this is the equation one, I'll write it. I'll go for next page. So this will become mv square by 3. So length of the plank will be 2V square by 3 mu g we are getting.
Why did you equate with 10V square by 3?
There is a network done by friction. No? Friction does negative work on the plank. Eh?
Inelastic collision takes place,
no, sir. Because of that, the relative motion friction will act, no? And the moment as it starts entering again,
there is no friction between A and B, no, sir.
No, this friction is what I'm showing it here. I'm unable to show it here. There's a friction between A and C only. It does negative work on A and does positive work on C. There's no friction between A and B. This is what the distance x. for this normal contact rod pen, only this part of the weight has to be taken. That's why we have broken up things like this here. Okay, but somewhere we are getting.
How can we take directly net change in kinetic energy, sir? From the initial to final state, how can we take kinetic energy change as work done by friction?
Oh, some energy is lost during collision, no?
Yes, sir. So from the second.
The second diagram.
Sir, from second diagram and third.
Initial kinetic energy. Yeah. Final speed of the each board, I think that is no problem. Okay, that I had to put it. Okay, I got it. No. So Kf will be, I think to calculate this, let me call K dash. Okay, here I'm going wrong. Yeah. I should start from second diagram, no? From here. What is this kinetic energy? Mv square, K dash will calculate. K dash will be mv square by 2, 2 m v by 2 whole square. Mv square will come. Fine. Okay, this mv square. Okay,
2 m by 2 v by 2.
1 by 2 will be there. 1 by 2. This will be 1/4. Yeah, 1/4 will be there. So this will be 3/4. Here, 3/4. Anybody value? 4 to 8. 8 minus 9 by. Twelve will come. Yeah. Check once. I think I should. This is a network done by friction. Mv square by 12. Okay, now we'll equate here. Mv square by 12. How much will get it? 6 will come. Okay, we'll check the options here. If you want any other method, you can apply. I felt like conservation of momentum a little bit. If you take it, no, it'll be easier for us. Okay, this K dash, you remember K here, huh? Because some energy lost during collision that has to be taken care. You see that what we're getting, the length of the plank depends on mu. Is it justified, or it's only numerical relationship we brought it? If I change length of the plank, well, mu will change. I wanted to just interpret this. Is it like that? No, this is some sort of numerical condition. It is not like something like if you change length of the plank, mu will change. Mu is what? Property of surface, no? So we should not conclude in that way again. Again, if you change length of the plank, okay, for again, it may not be in this position. It may be somewhere here or before reaching totally on C. It may some length of like a plank A, what happened, will be there on B. It can happen, but don't conclude in this way again. By changing length, the mu will change. So mu is a property of two surfaces. Doesn't depend upon the physical length. Okay, I think this will be very dangerous, huh? So don't relate anything L and mu. Okay, I'll take the next one. You read, I'll adjust these things.
sir.
Ah.
We wrote it as net change in kinetic energy of C as work done by friction on Cena, sir.
Friction does negative work on Planck A and does positive work on Planck C. That's the meaning, no?
Yes, sir, some energy is lost during collision, no, sir. So taken from the initial to final state.
No, no, this one K dash, that's why I replaced, no?
That one, sir, work done by friction on C.
Oh, this also, work done by friction on the C should be. Ah, the plate C was at rest, no? You
yes,
see
sir.
That one. The plate C, has it is having velocity V by 2.
During collision,
okay,
there is
no work done by friction. Mm-hmm. Okay, this one. I think I forgot this one. Huh? Okay.
Yes, sir.
I think that collision one, I'm totally forgetting. This also some correction is needed because collision occurs. I'm trying to totally forget that collision. Collision occurs after collision V by 2. Now the friction will act into picture. Yeah, fine, fine. This how much will come then? This will be here. It will be mv square by 8. So for this, we'll subtract mv square by 8. Mv in anybody value.
Seven mv square by 72.
Sir, how did you got K dash, sir? K dash is the kinetic energy. K dash is mv square plus mv by 2. Whole square plus mv by 2 whole square. That's why the 2 is brought here.
Okay, sir.
K dash is for total. This is for total. I think I will. Not for one plate, for total it is. Okay, I think that collision one, I think we are like a how high forgot, no? It may happen for you also. In between, some collision occurred and there is some energy lost during collision. I think let me write that comment somewhere here. Some energy lost during collision. That will write it here. So that will be more useful for us. No? Some kinetic energy is lost. During collision, I think this is something very important for us, huh? Because neglecting this will have a lot of impact on the problem. Our answers will go wrong. Almost all answers will go wrong. I think such questions can be asked in advance. Huh? It's a simple idea based. Okay, we'll take the next one. Any idea, college, any opening, any information, anybody? College reopening, any information?
No information is given, sir.
No information. Because in Karnataka, okay, it started and I don't know what will happen, but as such, even for LKG, UKG also, they have started. Nursery also, it started. Almost all, everything is as started. Not like only 9, 10, 11, 12. All the sections, total education department got opened. Hope, I think after Sankranti, we may expect January 20th. After January 18, we may expect the reopening of colleges. Okay, read the question. Yeah. Both are of same length, in, so both when they come, I think it's a purely some diagram based. So let's analyze through the diagram. both are of same length. The strings. Let me take two different strings so that we can recognize. So this is the bob. So they when they come to the or the state of them, the balls will have actually they are a bob. No, you treat like a point mass. To explain the problem, I had to show some shape, so therefore I just took that one. So they will have velocity, both will have same velocity initially. U at the length is L, so U should be equal to root GL. Root 2 GL. So this is the mass M, small m. The collision is perfectly elastic. So after collision, what happened? So their velocities, they will rebound. I think, okay, what? Okay, there's a better diagram, yeah. Collision is elastic, no? So will they have same speed or different speed after collision? So let me, different, so V1 and V2. If the ball of M reaches the maximum height, which is allowed, what is the maximum height allowed? Maximum height allowed is this one only. So the maximum height allowed. So the ratio of m by m can be, so we know initial velocity, they'll collide. Now, can it complete vertical circular path? I think it should be no. It is not something, it cannot come to rest here. So it should have some velocity. So what is that velocity? We know this velocity should be V4, I'll write it. So what is V4? V4 should be equal to, all the calculation part we'll see it. So this will be the circular path. Okay, V4 should be equal to root GL. Then V2 should be equal to root 5 GL. We should not assume it to be a test, huh? That may think that one. So when V2 is root 5 GL, apply conservation of momentum. Mu minus small mu should be equal to m small m v2 minus capital M v1.
Why can't v4 be 0, sir? It only maximum height.
Vertical circular motion, can it come to rest here? Possible, huh? In vertical circular motion.
In vertical circular motion, sir. He said maximum height.
See, maximum height is only this is possible. Can it come to rest at this particular point? If it comes to rest here, anything, it will leave circular path in this region. If it can reach us here, means it must have some velocity. It cannot come to rest here, I feel. Okay, I'm just taking help of, I'm taking vertical circular motion. So is it possible this bob can be at rest at this point? So it must have some minimum velocity here. So this is the possible maximum height. So as it completes vertical circle, so therefore V4 should be equal to root GL. So V2, I know it is root 5 GL, MV1. Okay, they'll collide elastically. This is the one equation. They collide elastically. Mu square, small mu square. MV1 square. Solving these two, I think the unknowns are that this V1 I can replace solving for small m by capital M. Can you work out this idea? You'll get the answer. Okay, two options are there. I don't know some. Which is allowed m by m can be allowed is Stirlinger. So the two will get eliminated. So m u square will be 2GL m plus 2GL equal to m v1 square, v2 square, we know it. V2 will be 5GL. So this will become M. Two M GL minus 3M GL equal to MV1 square. Okay, no, let me call this as equation 2. Substituting for V1 will be 2 in 1 and solve for capital M by small m. Now, why that allowed is telling? So you see again, the thing is allowed word is brought here.
Get greater than some values.
Yeah, this in fact, it is V2 will be even greater than root 5 GL also. It can complete vertical circular path. No, from there, the conditions will come. So the vertical circular motion is what the idea is very important. Am I right? No. Even if V2, 6GL, 7GL, then also it'll complete vertical circular motion. So then check the conditions here. So it's simple ideas, very, very, very important, especially advanced, no? You read the question. I'll finish off the diagram. Yeah. There's a mass m, 2m. We have very less problems on power. Very, very less problems are there on power. All possibility of asking some good questions on the power. So you check it, all the textbooks, everything, even my notes. You may get maximum at the most some 10, at the most maximum 10, I feel. The remaining smalls are there, math-based question, but something like some application-based, like through diagrams. Math-based questions are plenty, but through diagram-based, there are only 10 are there in the total book. So definitely a good number of numericals are needed. So what to do? Go back to pulley and wedge constraints so you can discuss about the power aspect in almost every numerical. That's what I took one problem from the wedge constraint. I'm just bringing it here. Now, what is the system telling? What will they find the average power applied by the external force on the system in an interval of time T naught at T equals the system is at rest, all surfaces are smooth. I'll apply force such that the blocks will be at rest relative to this one. So the total system is accelerating A naught. Okay, this will be M A naught. This will be N1, MG, tension, this is a tension. Here N2, here pseudo force 2M A naught. Okay, these are the forces are acting. So I'm interested. So the blocks are at rest in which frame in this particular? The person standing on the wedge, what will say that? The blocks are. What this person says? So then M A naught equal to 2MG. If you want, I'll come by. T minus MA naught equal to 0, T minus 2MG equal to 0. So therefore, A naught equal to 2G. Okay, I got this particular thing. So first we'll calculate what is the external force I should apply. What is the external force in the ground frame? You see that all three are moving, no? All three are moving with a common acceleration. So 7M plus M plus 2M A naught. So 10M into 2G. So then after certain time, what is the certain time T naught is asking? So what is the acceleration 2G? So what is the power generated at any time T? We'll write it. Speed of the wedge at any time T will be this much here. So what is the power generated by extra agent? F external into V. What is F external? 20MG. Into V, or this should become equal to 20mg 2gt or 40mg square t. Average power in an interval of time t. Okay, this is average power. So very nice problem, sir. You should really, I think, in exam. So students, what they do? Power means either they go for I'll calculate the kinetic energy, change in kinetic energy, time interval. There's instantaneous power. Average power means calculate power as a function of time. Then its average value, you know, there's a basic method. What are other things? What is the power generated by normal contact on the wedge? Yes, in fact, the normal contact will act on the wedge, no? This 2 MA naught is a pseudo force. Huh? this will be normal contact. What will happen here? It does positive work on the block. It does negative work on the wedge. This normal contact will be zero, and the tension, you see that one. It does negative work on the wedge. Does positive work on the block. So O will accelerate this block, the tension. So the tension does negative work. Normal contact does negative work on the wedge. The tension does positive work on the block. What is the work done by the gravity? Power generated by gravity will be zero. You see that one. There's no change in gravitational potential energy. Make observation. So I suggest you go back to wedge constraint. You see, I brought wedge constraint problem only, nothing big. Different. See, like rather than in exam, you should be ready. If you look at our books, no, we don't have any discussion about the power. My exam questions are based on mass based. No, some they give power as a function of time. They'll ask you velocity, speed, acceleration, distance covered, so many other things. All the wedge constraint problems we can analyze the power concept. Even in police also we can bring. I'll slide down. Read the question. Read the question. Hurry up. We'll try to speed up. So there's a small block. I'll give the question. I'll draw the diagram. Okay, there's a thing. So the particle is here. Let me write M1 and M2. This is theta. It was given velocity. You can see that one. So you I think is asking somewhere. So here, the wedge is placed. This part of the sentence, you try to read it. Small disk is projected towards wedge with an initial velocity u. Okay, that the initial velocity u is this one here. This is at rest initially. This is M2, this is M1. That is slides up the inclined face and then slide down. Assuming transit time of disk on the curved entry is negative, find the displacement of wedge when the disk is at the highest point on the wedge. And that is slides up the inclined face and then slides down. What do you mean by this? I think this sentence, you should have. So means it'll just come to rest here with respect to wedge, it'll come to rest, then it will slide down. Find the displacement of the wedge when the disk is at highest point. I think we have to, so many things we are supposed to understand from the condition given. The block will slide up. By the time when the block reaches here, it will come to rest with respect to wedge. Then the wedge will be moving continuously towards right and it will slide down. So by the time when the block reaches here, what is the displacement of wedge? Can we apply center of mass concept? Options are for you. It's left to you. As there is a normal contact force is acting. N sine theta, or we'll take component of here only. So this is N sine theta. So what is the motion of the wedge? Will be accelerated motion. So there's a point B. So let me take this is A. So it will have at any instant of time, let V be the velocity, forces acting, mg sine theta, mg cos theta, pseudo force, we are describing motion of the block with respect to which, then it will undergo retardation. If you want to write VR, design. So normal contact first we'll get it. N M1 A2 sine theta minus mg cos theta equals zero. So what is the normal reaction? Is equal to mg cos theta minus M1 it is. M1 g cos theta minus M2 A sine theta. This is the normal contact. So on the wedge, so what is n value, we know it. I'll substitute that. Both are same as, no? Mass of the wedge is equal to mass of, okay, since both are same mass, okay, let me take. Okay, calculations will be very easy. Okay, further A2, so what is N? Mg cos theta. A2 will be g sine theta cos theta by 1 plus sine square theta. This is the acceleration of wedge with respect to ground. So we know acceleration. So if we can calculate time taken by the block to come to rest with respect to wedge at point B, I'll get that time. Then x equal to of a to t square. So how, let's concentrate on the block. So time taken by the block to move from a to b on the wedge, that will calculate, that is what I'll call t. So what is t now? Time taken by block . Okay, what was initially? The wedge was at rest, so velocity of block with respect to wedge will be u only, the moment it enters here. And finally, it will come to rest relative to wedge. So shall we go for this one? Zero equal to ur. Minus ar t. Ur is nothing but u only. Because initially the wedge was at rest. What is AR? AR will be G sine theta plus A2 cos theta. What is A2? A2 value we know it. So this will be U G sine theta . Okay, finally, I got the time plus sign it is here. Yeah. Can we simplify this further?
Sir, okay, sine theta by 1 plus sine square theta.
G sine theta, 2G sine theta.
One plus sine square theta by 2g sine theta.
By 2g sine theta. Okay, the expression for this t. After getting this t, okay, solve this. I'll write the final answer. U square 2 cos theta okay, do calculation later on. Huh? Can we use center of mass concept unnecessarily? Not motion of the block with respect to wedge, if center of mass, will it continue? No disturbance? Yeah. Let me. Now can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, now what will happen to center of mass? Okay, first the block, when the block is initially, center of mass will be moving. When the block is sliding on the west, center of mass will be moving with constant speed. The same thing in same initial direction. Then when block is at rest with respect to wedge on the wedge at point B, then also the center of mass will continue. When the block is sliding down also, the center of mass will move towards right with a uniform velocity because there's no net force on system along x-axis. So therefore you calculate velocity of center of mass. It will be U by 2, remains constant. Remained constant with time. That's all, finish all. The total problem, what happened even after block sliding down again reaches to the ground, then also the center of mass will continue its uniform velocity motion. More than one options will ask you this center of mass idea also. We may think that afterwards it will move towards left. No, there's no net force on system along x-axis. So initial velocity of center of mass is U by 2. So it will continue to remain. When the block is sliding up on the incline, sliding down the incline, when the block is moving on the ground towards right or towards left, the center of mass will be moving towards right only with a velocity U by 2. Shall I put it? U by 2 I can. This is the condition. Yeah. We'll take the next one. A person will walk on the wedge, constant speed u relative to wedge. Okay, there's a mass m1, m2, this is theta. Okay, he will walk up with a speed ur. Okay, no, go back. It's what is u? U is the speed of the person with respect to wedge. And this is rough. Okay, carefully analyze the diagram. And this is smooth. This is smooth. Nice question. Again, learning the power concept. What are the forces? We list out the forces acting. So normal contact, N, and the normal contact. There's a component of that will act here in sine theta, in cos theta. How the friction on the person should act, the net friction, it is, don't take that only the friction acting on, the total friction acting on the person should be up the incline, on the wedge will be down the incline. In what possible direction the wedge can move? It's moving up the incline. So therefore, let's assume that velocity of the wedge be V2. Why should move towards right? Component of friction will be greater than n sin theta. I am assuming it will move towards right here. Let's analyze now. It's asking the power due to normal contact force on man is non-zero. Power due to normal contact force on man is non-zero. So first I'll get into some method calculations part. So what is along x-axis towards left? I'll take it negative. And anything towards right, let it be positive. So minus ur cos theta. Ur cos theta. This should be equal to velocity of the person, we don't know. Minus the velocity of the wedge will be along x-axis. No, along x-axis it is. So therefore, this will be u1x is equal to v2 minus ur cos theta. This is the velocity of the person with respect to ground. Similarly, what is u1y? Should be equal to ur sine theta. If you want, you better write I cap u1xy or define coordinate axis. And what is the velocity of man with respect to incline should be? V2 sine theta, because as normal contact is zero. So what is the velocity of man with respect to normal? Because velocity along common normal should be equal. Am I right? Velocity along common normal must be equal. So therefore, velocity of the wedge with respect to ground is V2. Component of velocity in this direction, V2 sine theta. So therefore, velocity of man. I'm taking help of some basic constraint equations. Velocity of man with respect to wedge perpendicular to incline. V2 sine theta. Any reason for that? Normal contact is non-zero. That's all. Therefore, what is the work done by normal contact? It should be equal to n into V2 sine theta. In fact, it is non-zero, no? You can check it. Normal contact on the person. On man is non-zero. The friction force acting on man is mg sine theta, naturally.
Sir, it is power, no sir, not work done.
Oh, powers, I'll write it. Normal contact into speed. Yeah, symbol I changed it. What is this? Power due to normal contact force on man. Okay, the first one, I'll pick up the option. Okay, I do have. And the friction force acting on man is mg sin theta, is moving with a constant speed relative to which, as it is. Power due to friction on man is zero. How to get the option C? power due to normal contact force on the wedge is positive. Power due to normal contact force on the wedge is positive. So this will be n sine theta minus
negative. Negative, no, sir.
Should be negative. Huh? It should be negative.
On wedge, it will be negative. Both are in opposite direction.
Yeah, that is the thing. So this ruled out. What about power due to friction on man is zero? Can we prove it?
It will not be zero.
F into U R, F into U, power due to friction on man is zero. I think this is ruled out. F into U, that's all. So power by friction. So this F you don't write mu n, it's like a static friction. U R, I'll write it here. This is. Okay, this is also non-zero. So what is this? Power by on person. Okay, it will be negative. So instead of positive, negative, we could have picked up here. There's one good problem I brought it. Through potential energy, I'm entering into the circular motion concept. Read carefully. So from potential energy, first what we can find out? You can find out the force. Okay, from the force, we can go for tangential normal acceleration. I think there's the idea, no? It's a purely math based, need not to draw so many diagrams. First we calculate as x and y coordinates are given. No? So the function is there, the function is available. We'll differentiate with respect to x, with respect to y. Then we'll get x component of force acting on particle, y component of force. Then after getting that force, then we'll come back, we'll see that how do I can get that tangential as well as normal components of acceleration. Okay, let's come to the question later on. First, we'll calculate the force. So what is the function given? U is equal to kx can be asked. If you look at the advanced paper, some related to work potential, also conservative forces, all that they're given. So the possibility, like usually we have this particular problems where the potential energy function will be given. From the potential energy function, not get saved. From potential energy function, what we get usually force. Under action of that force, that particular particle will accelerate, will retard. So some questions of that, those kind is what we are discussed here. So now something I'm bringing the idea of circular motion through potential change. Okay, workout, I'll try to save. It is not responding. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now it is stopped. I'll get back the screen here. Yeah. how much of time it will take. Oh. Just wait, I'll get it back. Okay, now this is about the x component of force, similarly y component of force. So differentiating this with respect to y, will get this one. So this will be 3kx square by, okay, now see this. So these are the forces what we have.
3kx square by y. 3kxy by x square plus y square whole raised to the power of 5 by 2.
Fy, what?
Yes, sir.
Only this much. With respect to y, I'm differentiating, no?
Yes, sir. Now it will be 5 by 2 now, sir, power.
Now the denominator 5 by 12 make it.
Up will get xy, not x square.
Xy will come,
huh? Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, this is about the x sign, y component of the forces. no negative sign. Yeah, I will not be there. Yeah. Now. Okay, let's get into the question now. So some of this is mathematics. It is at a position R naught I cap plus J cap. Somewhere in the corner. Let me take this. So R naught. Okay, there's a point. So the particle is here. What are the forces that are acting? It is experiencing a force Fx. So I'll take that force Fx in this direction. Then it will experience a force Fy component, y component of force, this Fx component. Then what do you mean by, if it is a position R bar equal to R naught I cap, the particle is observed moving perpendicular to R bar. The particle is observed perpendicular to R bar. So okay, perpendicular. So shall we take, so this is the thing, and this will be the normal. I'll extend with the same color. Yeah. So shall we take, this is N cap. This is something T cap. This R bar. So we can, and what can be this angle? This angle should be 45. This is 45. So he's asking now to get the normal component and tangential component. Tangential component means, so shall I take the difference of these components, these two? Normal means I'll add up the components of the force along n cap by mass will become the tangential accelerations. Okay, let me just roughly put it. So this will be A tangential. This will be A normal. So what is A tangential? So A tangential should be equal to Fy sine 45 minus Fx cos 45 by M. Do we know Fy and Fx where the particle is at distance, how much it is? R naught and R naught. So we'll substitute now. Put X and Y, put X equal to R naught, Y equal to R naught, and get the magnitude of that force. You are able to see screen, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, then. Yeah. Okay, we'll calculate the magnitude of force at we'll get the magnitude of force. So this will be, I think, K2K R naught. Shall I write directly? 3K. This one.
K by 4 root 2 R cube.
Fx is needed, no? So K by 2 to power of 5 by 2 R naught cube. This is Fx. Similarly, Fy will be 3K 2 to power of. Check once, because again, okay, this one. So there's a tangential. Substitute that particular value, then we'll get the a tangential. So Fy will be 3k 2 to power of 5 by 2 r naught cube 1 by root 2 Fy. This will be k 1 by root 2. So, all divided by mass. So, with this, what happened? We'll get the tangential acceleration. Minus k 4m r naught cube. Similarly, what is a normal? A normal, I'll add up this component. So, Fy cos 45. Fx will be k by 2 to power of 5 by 2 I'll write in vector form. So a norm k by 2 k by 2m r naught. K by 2 2m r naught cube. He's asking find the tangential component of acceleration of particle at this point. So you can write in vector form. Now you know at cap. So what is at bar should be equal to
minus will not come.
This negative will not be there. So at should be equal to at minus at cos 45 I cap plus at sine 45 j cap. Now there's a very good problem where some from potential j we are entering into circular motion. So at I think by root 2, so this will be at by root 2 minus ij. So this will become k 4 root 2 m r naught cube similarly. What is an an should be I cap plus j cap it should be. So an bar should be equal to what are that angles an sine 45 it was there in Pathfinder. So even you check the advanced, no? From potential energy, we don't have any relationship with respect to the circular motion. I just picked up one of the question. Is it a circular motion? We don't know. It can be curvilinear because the acceleration is there. For a normal, there should be some velocity, no? So if we give radius of curvature, we can predict the speed of the particle also. I'm unable to show that particular speed. It should be along opposite to at or in the direction of at certain speed. If they give speed, then what we can do, we can calculate the radius of curvature. I think the problem still may ask you of like this, huh? Because we know a normal, so we will be somewhere here like this. Then if you know a normal and the speed of particle, you can bring the radius of curvature. If he gives radius of curvature, we can bring the tangential speed. Getting the picture? So these are some math based questions. So purely what you should just have the basic thing. The moment you get potential, you'll get the force. That's all whole. From force, okay, any other quantities we can predict. Okay, we'll take this one more question. Read this one. So from tower. I'll project a particle with a kinetic energy k. Or let me write that initial velocity t equals zero having mass m. So it's going to describe a path and it'll come and strike the ground. So when it strikes the ground, it will have x component, y component. I think this is a time of flight. Tau is what it's giving, and this is a range. There's some viscous drag is also present. So let's go for at any time t. At any time t, when the particle is here, what are the forces that are acting? Mg. The viscous drag, how the viscous drag should act? Then it is having x component and y component. These are the final. At any time t, this is a situation. What was the initial kinetic energy? It was given for us, k. So therefore, the k is what? Mu square by 2, u equal to 2k by m. So we're all needed. That is the initial velocity it was projected. Let's get into the problem. Find the horizontal range of the ball. It's asking to get the expression for r in terms of that k. And the force of a drag is proportional to speed v. Proportional is telling. Only there is information what we have. So it's a definitely viscous drag. So the viscous drag should be equal to alpha v. That alpha we don't know. That we'll try to determine.
Thank you, sir.
Proportionality constant is k. Oh, it's available, no? Yeah. I didn't see it. I'll make it alpha because that small k, capital K. Let's get into this one here. Yeah. Okay, see, we are discussing horizontal projectile with viscous drag. There's only the concept of this one. Nothing big is there. So at any instant of time, so let this be the theta. So therefore, this will be theta. No. So what is the retardation along x-axis? Ax should be equal to minus fv sine theta by m. So the viscous drag is equal to, this will become alpha v sine theta by m. This ax, I'll write it as v dv x by x equal to alpha v. Alpha v it is speed v sine theta by m. So what is Vx? Vx should be equal to speed of particle is v. So Vx should be equal to v sine theta. Simple problem. Only thing is the we should take care of the mathematical conditions very clearly. So minus alpha m. This will be dx. So from here, I'll bring expression for the range. Initial velocity, how much it is given? It is u naught. Finally, it is vx. Here, the horizontal range will be 0 to capital R. This is what being asked us, no? Vx minus u naught equal to minus alpha r by m. Keep this equation 1 in hand. The same Ax, which is there. So this will, can also be written as dvx by dt, because we know time of flight, no? So this will be dvx, v sine theta. V sine theta, what you can write it as, vx. So dvx by dt minus alpha by m into vx. Initial velocity of the particle, u naught. Finally, it is vx only. This is tau. So this will become log of vx by u naught minus alpha tau by m. Or what is the value? Vx equal to u naught e to the power of minus alpha tau by m. So that Vx we don't know. So that I'm going to substitute there. So from solving 192, Vx value will be u naught e to power of minus alpha tau by m minus u naught minus alpha r by m. So the expression for r. One more step, I think we'll get it. This one, u naught. M by m u naught by alpha. Can be asked, simple mathematics. I think somehow we should analyze that tau and r is given, no? So taking help of that tau and r, if it gives height, I would have took the y component. Since we have information about only the x component of velocity more, that's why I just took help of x component of velocity. Purely, I think, may not be less concept, the more about the basic idea that one. So that there's some, what methodology you're going to take help of here. The information what we have is like a some tau. Okay, so then I'll bring h. Okay, you can, since you know tau, you can bring also for h. Take y component of velocity and get into the problem. Since what we have, see, why I'm taking it is like the x component of initial velocity is what we know. So therefore, I just took x component of acceleration. I just carried on the problem. And these are very important in advance. So just wanted like students, how we'll manage things. This will be really time killing. You solve by take y component or x component. Since we have information of range, no, the limits will be very easier. Since you have tau, then you have to make a guess of height. H equal to half g tau square. Then from h, you should bring tau. Then you have to solve. Then component of viscous drag, you have to take it here in this direction. Then I think it'll be complicated. You see, along y-axis, why I'm trying to avoid is like mg minus fv sine theta equal to MAY, the integration will become very lengthy for you. Therefore, I just took help of motion along x-axis only, I analyzed it. We have other problems. Okay, tomorrow we'll continue from here. Tomorrow, I think will be the last Friday, no? This will be, I'll try to bring some other different numericals. Okay, thank you all of you. I'm not giving